So this is example two on Edberg limit tests. And we are given liquid limit test result, and we're going to calculate the liquid limit LL and also flow index IF. So that's this is a very, very simple example. So first, what's given here, we have three soil samples, and each one has a different moisture content. And the N values recorded for the three soil samples are listed here as well. So the first thing is to basically plot this N value versus moisture content. So you have this N versus moisture content plot. And remember, this is a semi-log plot. So N value is in log scale. And the data points, three data points are shown on this slide. And then if you fit a straight line, so that's what we defined in Monday's lecture, that's called flow curve. So then for a liquid limit, so liquid limit is defined as the N value corresponding to, the moisture content corresponding to N equals to 25. So it basically starts from N of 25. And then you find the corresponding moisture content. By definition, that's liquid limit. It's about 39%. So that's the N that, that's a liquid limit, LL. And then the flow index, IF, so LL, is about 39%. And the flow index, IF, is defined as, it's basically the slope of this flow curve. Okay. And so you can pick any two data points to calculate the slope. So I'm going to pick first and the last one. So I'm going to use this one here and this one here. But again, you can pick any two points. So that's 42. Minus 39.3 over log of 28 divided by 15. Okay. So again, any two points are okay. I'm picking the first and last one to calculate the slope. And this is 9.96. Okay, and then for liquid limit, actually, it's actually, to be more precise, this is 39.5, actually. But 39 is it's a pretty good estimate. Okay, so that's example two, Edberg limit tests.